Hi, welcome to the 23rd Udine Far East Film Festival, and thank you all for watching the film Hanro Cigarette. My name is Kevin Ma. I am the host of this Q&A session. Today we have two very special guests in matching outfits. First, on the left, he's a free runner and he's making his film acting debut as Manny in the film Hanro Cigarette. Please say hi to Bipin Karma.
Hi guys.
And then here in the center, you might have seen as an actor in films like Midnight After and The Crossing. Here he's the writer and director of Hanro Cigarette. Please say hi to director Chen Kim Lo.
Hello.
Okay. So, 咁我哋第一個問題就先問下導演先啦。 你入行嗰陣係做咗演員，但係你讀書嗰陣其實係 係拍片啊，或者係冇做幕前嘅多。咁點解你會揀《手卷煙》呢一個故事作為你第一套嘅導演作品咧？其實《手卷煙》一開頭我係同另一個
scriptwriter 一齊去諗嘅時候，就諗緊一個關於香港嘅故仔。咁但係點樣為之香港咧？我哋諗咗好耐都揾唔到一個適合嘅角色嘅身份。咁到最尾，我哋就將個範圍收窄到華籍英軍。 因為華籍英軍呢一個部隊係一個好特別嘅存在嘅喺香港嘅歷史嚟講，我哋用其他嘅職業都取代唔到，即係譬如我哋用警察、用公務員，甚至乎係日常嘅一啲職業都唔係嗰種獨特性嚟嘅。咁華籍英軍某程度上就係英殖時期佢哋經歷過97回歸，佢以前就 under 英國政府嘅，佢就係交税都係交税俾英女王嘅，但係解散之後佢哋嘅善後服務並不是太好。 即係港英政府同埋香港特區政府嗰時俾佢哋嘅退伍嘅一啲安排都比較差，咁佢哋就變咗係一個裂縫中裏邊生存嘅一個狀態。咁其實好描寫到或者刻畫到嗰一個 generation 嘅人嘅，特別係我爸爸嗰個 generation， 即係60歲左右。所以我哋就用咗呢一個做切入點去講呢個故仔咯，就衍生到 身份，然後到情義，到 generation 隔代嘅唔同嘅睇法咯。
Okay, so Bipin, this is your first acting in a film.
Yes.
How did you land this opportunity, or was that something you had planned to do, or how did it land on your lap?
Yeah. Well, before I was into this field, I was actually doing behind the scenes, meaning that I was doing a little bit of camera work, a little bit of writing. And director Chen Kim Long, he actually saw one of my short film, which I initially was like writing only, but then I couldn't find an actor for that, so I was like, okay, maybe the producer and I decided we could actually have me act on that, and that didn't be. And he saw that, and he was like, oh, maybe I could ask him to come along, and he asked me to come along to do a meetup to know about the film, and that's how we connected actually. So you could say he watched a short film of mine, which was accidental of me to be in acting, and yeah, that's.
But he rejected me in the very beginning, so I think he's so arrogant.
No.
But why did you reject it in the beginning?
Oh no, because you know this is the first time for me to act. First of all, I never had an acting experience. And even my Guangdonghua is not the best. You could see, so when people watch my Guangdonghua in Saokinyin and they see me in Q&A, they're like, oh, you can't speak Canto? I was like, no, I'm sorry. But so the Cantonese was overwhelming for me in the beginning. Even my Yantowa, which is Hindi, because I'm not Indian, I'm Nepalese. So I had to learn how to speak Hindi and also the accent and everything. So coming all together, I was like, perhaps I might not be the ideal candidate, especially having to know the fact that I was also having my last year in uni. And that moment I was like, oh, possibly I'm not ready yet. So
it's fate.
Eventually it was fate, you know. It's been a crazy ride until this point, and I know it's going to be a very, very great learning experience, but you know, that's how it started, from that little accident, a little fateful twist of moment.
So let's talk about the rest of the cast. 講下其他演員啦。你點樣揾到家棟啦，同埋當然其他個cast都好犀利啊。但係點樣去拼呢個cast出嚟嘅咧？
哇！我都係啱啱想講翻緣份咯，要 death fate 嗰啲。但係其實我覺得係，因為一開頭我啲 cast 都未定實嘅，尤其是係關於台灣黑幫嗰一個部分。因為台灣黑幫嗰個部分本身係諗住揾台灣嘅演員，就係、是、分別係陳竹升同埋莊振翼都有。跟住之後，因為陳竹升唔得，就問過吳彭鳳嘅。基本上佢哋都綠燈㗎啦，即係佢哋 say yes 㗎啦。但係因為嗰時 covid 好嚴重。所以他們就最後來不到，那時候唯有我想在香港演員裡面哪一些人或者什麼的前輩演員有那種台灣的感覺呢，那後來就想到泰寶，那就最後即是最後去 confirm 就是泰寶台灣幫那個角色，那其他演員包括、林家棟，那家棟哥那他都是那時候其實一開始我都想過其他的人選去做關超這個角色的，但後來見了家棟哥跟他談之後，我就覺得他是最適合去做關超這個角色，就很快就跟他去討論劇本的細節了。那還有就是其他角色，譬如何華超的角色，即是他都是退役的軍人，某程度上他想找何華超是想跟阿果那套去年煙花有一個聯繫的，因為我自己本身都很喜歡那套電影，因為都是講緊一個時代下面的小人物，那跟他的主題很相近，我也都是時代下面，不過我自己的想法就是在裂縫中行走的人，即是高、我們不停向前向上爬，但是你爬不到上去，但是當你一放鬆你放手，你就會跌落無底的深淵。那我自己覺得最後的 combination， 現在那個 cast 的 combination， 我覺得某程度上都是緣分來的，因為那時候都是疫情最嚴重的時候，但是很多演員的朋友或者演員的前輩看完劇本談完之後，他們都很願意 去一起投入去這個創作，所以我覺得是一個挺奇妙的事的。
是的，正如你所說，剛剛說套戲是2020年3月拍的嘛，就是剛剛疫情開始的時候，那你們那時候有沒有猶豫是否應該繼續拍，還是你們怎樣 去終於完成套戲呢？在這個疫情底下，
我們其實都中間停過一次的，就是 production 上面，但是因為我們的資金比較有限制，所以我們不可以停太久，所以都決定繼續拍。但是怎麼決定繼續拍的時候，就第二波的疫情，就是我們2020年的年頭，就是最嚴重的第二波。都想過可不可以再 delay 呢，但是跟每一個部門甚至乎跟演員談，他們都覺得不如繼續吧，如果我們小心一點。因為我其實跟家棟哥說過的，家棟哥就答我說如果要中就真的中了，我們小心一點拍就 OK 了。就是這一句就凝聚了所有人一起 去拍攝，我覺得這一個心態是很重要
的。 So Bipin, Tin Long was just talking about shooting during the pandemic, so you were surrounded by all these veteran actors, it's a high pressure environment, you got shot in 18 days, it's your first time acting, so what was the experience like for you overall?
Yeah, I meanI met Lam Ka Tong, Gordon Lam, in the rehearsal, and he gave me this energy that, you know, this is gonna be a wild experience for me. Whereas, like, she said, I also mentioned so many times before that, he said, you are Manny, the character. And when he said that, for me, it was, okay, I gotta do my inner work. And almost like brainwash myself to become Manny, because he saw that I had that something of Manny in me. And I might have not seen it in the beginning, but that was one thing. But working with the whole cast, there were like Bati, Typo, and all the other cast, they had a very good vibe, but at the same time, our crew was very young. And I also told, I remember I told the crew, like, our crew is really young and so fresh, and I just felt like it was just a historical moment, especially for, I don't know, for me, because it just seemed fresh for me. And having to know that my brothers, my Pugo was an Indian descent, my Manso was Pakistani and me being Nepalese, having that brother, different nationality, it was quite historical for Hong Kong movie to have that thing. So the casting and everything, I was discussing with Tan Kin Long, like, you really, really gave a lot of thought into the casting. And, you know, and everything was put out really, really well. Me, if I'm talking from outside an actor, you know, it was just great. You know, I learned from a lot from Gordon Lam, just observing him, being in the zone. So it was great.
I mean, you had most of your scenes with Gordon, right? And with such short time, how did you guys build that chemistry on the screen? Did you guys work together? Did you guys rehearse a lot before a shoot?
We apparently we did not rehearse a lot. We just had a few rehearsals, but every rehearsal was very meticulous. I mean, I paid attention and I was
like
nervous.
An intensive course.
I was nervous. Also course. Because it was very cold that time, so I was like shaking when I met Gordon Lam. But everything that he said, I was like really trying to understand, you know. Especially, he gave me a very good advice of writing down what my past was, my background, and also what my motive was. And on the first day, I had a notepad, and I was just sitting in the corner just trying to brainwash myself just before the scene. And some of the crew member came up to me like, "Are you okay, bro? Like, you can chill down." And I'm like, yeah, I should. And then after a while, I started to slowly become a bit comfortable and more like relaxed. Because on the first day, you can ask him, it's like, are you okay? So, but you know, it was great.
But I do think Bipin is talented in acting, so he get used to the environment in very soon. So yeah, I think he's good.
I had to try extra hard. I mean, it was my first time acting, and he literally put me in a position where it's like, act. It's like big thing. Oh, this is one of the main characters, act. And I'm like, okay. So I have to do a lot of groundwork and a lot of, basically studying and homework. So,
and the hard work really paid off. It was a great performance.
Yeah. The audience will decide after that. And for sure, we're getting a great feedback slowly, and I hope the audience will like it.
Yeah. 我哋講下個製作方面啦，因為套戲係首部劇情電影計劃嘅戲啦。 咁大家都知道個 budget 係唔會好高。咁你喺拍攝嗰陣，你點樣去平衡，就係話你得到你想拍嘅，同埋去 make sure 套戲唔會過呢個預算咧？其實我諗。
雖然有 budget 嘅限制，但係最主要係大家都有團火，即係我覺得香港電影或者港產片就係大家拼死去做嘅嗰個決心。咁其實好多地方或者好多場景其實都基本上好難喺我哋呢個預算度做到，但係我哋諗辦法去資源分配咯。因為譬如有一啲場口，有一啲 plot 係喺關超屋企嘅，咁我哋就喺嗰度濃縮，盡量喺嗰度解決拍咗佢。然後譬如後面有一啲打嘅場口或者一啲比較大嘅場口，我哋就將啲時間資源擺翻落嗰度多啲咯。咁其實取捨咯，變相其實對於演員嚟講都好 harsh 嘅，因為喺室內嘅文戲咧，佢哋係需要比較短嘅時間我哋要解決或者我哋要處理完成。咁但係都好彩，嘉棟哥同 Bipin 入到去嗰個 chemistry 好。 好快佢哋已經有，即係有想要嘅感覺，都係好少嘅微調。咁但係如果調翻轉，如果 Touchwood 嗰時係，即係佢哋冇咁好 chemistry 咧，可能出嚟嘅效果或者嗰個戲都未必有嗰個味道出到嚟。嗰個
long take 係咪你最難堅持嗰樣嘢，定係嗰個係咪最難拍嗰個？反而
long take 就唔係最難堅持嘅，因為 long take 就係即係嗰個 shot 係一開頭已經諗住係咁噶啦，即係有少少 reference。 係朴讚旭嘅《原罪犯》，咁《朴讚旭原罪犯》唔係完全想 copy 佢，而係我覺得因為嗰個戲到後面就係想俾翻觀眾一個 impact 或者反思，就係第三者嘅角度咯，以一個抽離嘅角度去望翻一個 chaos 一個打鬥嘅發生，但係唔係好多時候我哋都會係第一身或者好近，因為如果好典型嘅動作處理就係會係 cut shot。 我哋好似好近佢哋個打鬥現場嘅，但係我今次想係一個第三者嘅角度去望翻，因為有幾多人 或者我哋去反思翻，我哋有幾多時候 chaos 發生嘅時候，我哋會喺裏邊咧，定係我哋都係用抽離嘅角度去睇咧？即係我希望呢度會有少少思考空間俾翻觀眾。
So Pepin, you didn't have to do the long take. I think you were kind of on the sideline, right? I remember.
I was literally lying down on the floor. There's a whole story to that.
Okay.
And so, because they were choreographing the whole sequence, and I was just on the position, and I was just looking at everybody, hoping that I would have my own movement, but they didn't, because I was trying to. There was the first take that we did, we're just rehearsing, and I was not clear about my own positions where I should move later on, because it's a long take. And I remember inside I was like, okay, I don't exactly know, but let me come inside Manny. What would he do in this moment? And I was like, oh, he would try to, at least, even though he's really, really damaged, he was almost gonna die, what would he do? And I was like, okay, I will try to at least reach out my hand and help out Gatong while he's really trying to fight everybody.
And then you look like a Pokemon.
Yeah, and he came up to me. He
said, in my finder.
Yeah, he said, cut, and he came up to me. He's like, you said, are you a caterpillar? Because I was just going around all the room, like just trying to like do that. But yeah, eventually we got the take, and yeah, it was cool.
So I'm going to take on a little more serious topic. I asked Pepin first, and then sure. Not many Hong Kong films, you know, tackle the theme of racism the way that this film does. It was very directly. So was that something that was on the back of your mind when you were acting the film?
I was aware that this context was in it, this discrimination, you know, segregation, and all that, and. For me, living in Hong Kong from the age of 8, there has been moment where, you know, I have had discrimination as well, and I know other people who have had discrimination as well. So I understood this topic from the very beginning, and from this movie, I could see that, you know, it is portrayed in a way where we're showing reality. For example, the word that is used, like tazai, the word that is used, it's there, but in a way where it's not trying to teach, like for example, it's not trying to show, like this movie is not trying to teach about other different culture. It's just showing this the reality and see what you think of it. Because the character of Manny is very innocent in his ways, and it's very much passive in his way, especially when he meets Gatong, Quan Chu, and he gets more of a more baby in a way, because he himself was abandoned by his parents. So he took this chance to feel more like, you know, a baby in his ways, and have that connection with them. So I guess it's a very different way of talking about discrimination, or talking about this issue of you know, living in a society about identity. Yeah.
導演咧，我再翻嚟多次，即係種族歧視喺香港電影真係好少話咁直接去探討呢個話題嘅。咁呢個係咪你？寫手卷嗰陣，呢個係你想做嘅嘢咧？
我覺得係其中一個附帶嘅議題嚟嘅，對我嚟講。咁譬如我哋成日會講香港係一個國際嘅大都會啦，即係中西文化係一個融合嘅大城市啦。但係某程度上，我哋又見唔到一啲唔同膚色嘅演員喺比較少啦，即係喺電影裏邊出現。咁我覺得呢樣嘢係。需要去咁樣做嘅，即係譬如我哋睇翻美國，睇翻 Oscar， 咁佢哋都有美籍非裔、美籍華裔，唔同顏色嘅人都可以喺電影呢個藝術裏邊出現，甚至乎可以參加到頒獎禮。咁點解我哋香港比較少呢？因為我哋有時去判斷其他人嘅時候係以顏色或者我哋眼睛去判斷。我哋譬如我哋試下將一個好流利講廣東話嘅印巴嘅朋友笠咗個紙袋。 你可能覺得佢係比你更本土，但係點解我哋會覺得佢唔係香港人或者唔係本土咧？係因為以顏色嚟區分。咁我就希望依樣嘢帶俾大家就係有時候唔係膚色上邊，而係你有冇真正用心去同人溝通。即係就算如果你有依個心去溝通或者去認識一個人嘅時候，就唔係膚色，唔係年齡，其實係就算價值觀唔同，我哋都可以交到心。
So this one I have to ask you first, because Kin Long has a model answer. So I should ask you first. The significance of the Hanro cigarette. In the film, obviously, it's a symbol of friendship between your character and Gordon's character. But do you think it stands for anything else? Is there any other significance to the actual Hanro cigarette?
I'm so careful.
Yeah, I'm so careful. I think it's just the process, you know, the process of putting the tobacco in the paper, rolling it up. That process is more meditative in a way. It's more like you are really taking the time to be in the present moment, you know, and be basically in that moment. So for me, it's just being more meditative. It will in that moment. So besides, you know, the passing off the saliva, because when you roll it up, it's your saliva. And as you said, if you pass it along, you're kind of sharing that intimate way. But before that, even if you're rolling by yourself, you're just being meditative in that process of rolling the paper. So that's, I guess, being the moment.
導演咧，即係除咗友誼呢樣嘢，手卷煙係有另外一個
意思咁。其實佢都答咗我嘅 model answer 啦。基本上，其實即係因為其實有時候手卷煙，譬如有食煙嘅朋友就會知道個分別咯。因為手卷煙我哋拎出嚟去 roll 一支煙，我哋絕對需要時間去消化或者有個 buffer 喺度啦。但係對於我哋而家好快速嘅城市人嚟講，永遠都係冇放慢。其實某程度上佢係一個放慢的態度，即係你點樣去感受一樣嘢咯。所以去捲支煙其實是俾自己冷靜落嚟，或者一個 buffer 去消化。咁我哋去高支煙的時候，我哋都有空間和時間，就唔係永遠都是快速咯。即係我譬如打一個比喻，我以前有夾 band 嘅，咁就譬如 Pink Floyd 嘅歌，以前我哋20分鐘，可能個 first 或者個 intro 三分鐘四分鐘都未有歌詞嘅，或者未入個 first 嘅。咁但係我哋會真係去聽佢嘅 structure 去感受嘅時候，就會另一個感覺，即係同食卷煙嗰個感覺或者個態度係相近嘅，即係我哋有冇放翻慢個人咧，去感受翻嗰件事咧，咁就係一個慢活嘅態度咯，對我嚟講。咁另外嗰樣嘢就係情意或者情感嘅傳遞啦。我依支煙我煲完之後，啱啱阿 Bip 都有講啦，即係個口水喺上邊，我哋去縫合去 pass 俾你，其實你接得咧。就是我哋有一定的感情基礎，或者我哋有一定的 friendship， 你先會去接我支煙。咁呢個就係情義之間嘅一個嘅象徵咯，一個嘅 symbol 咯。
有好多人將呢套戲同銀河影像嘅電影去比較啦。我唔知道你覺得點，定係其實真係有佢嘅影響喺裏邊咧，定係有其你自己有其他一啲influence 或者其他電影人係影響到你嘅。
其實其中一個最喜歡的香港導演就是杜琪峰導演，所以某程度上可能都有少少受到他影響嘅，因為我自己本身在個質感上或者個氣氛處理，我都很喜歡 high contrast 的東西，因為我同埋我覺得去拍呢套戲的時候，那個感覺那個壓迫感是用 high contrast 才可以營造到的，所以某程度上出嚟某一啲嘅氣氛，我覺得可能會似銀河影像，但我覺得未必完全係嘅，因為喺個鏡頭運用或者去講故仔嘅 present 出嚟嘅手法上邊，我覺得唔係完全相似，但可能喺個 cinematography 上邊嗰個氣氛會相近，即係如果出嚟，但係我自己係比較喜歡，即係我最喜歡嘅其中一個導演就係黑澤明導演，所以我喺一啲鏡頭上邊嘅處理都希望可以攞到一啲一啲用鏡頭講故仔嘅一啲處理放喺裏邊。
點解你冇喺幕前出現嘅喺呢套戲？定係因為你太忙做幕後嗰啲嘢？
因為太忙啦，因為如果你好專注做導演嗰、那個。 崗位嘅時候，基本上你好難分心，除非你好游刃有餘，或者你可以更加純熟地去處即係可以掌握到導演個技藝嘅時候。但係因為始終係第一套嘅長片咧，想個精神同心力主要放喺導演嘅崗位上邊，即係我成個架構啊、我嘅氣氛啊，或者我嘅 shot 同埋角色之間嘅關係去點樣處理咧，所以就今次 focus on 導演呢個身份。
咁近年咧都有好多香港嘅新導演出道啦，即係包括你啊，即係呢一代係有都有好多導演。咁你覺得呢一代嘅香港導演同之前嘅幾代嘅香港導演有冇啲咩唔同咧？
我覺得一定有嘅，即係未必係攞而家嚟做一個比較，但係每一個generation 嘅人都會有佢自己對世界嘅睇法或者佢嘅價值觀。咁相對地，如果而家新一批多咗導演出嚟，因為我哋容易咗可以接觸拍攝啦，但係仍然我哋嘅電影行業係相對困難嘅。但係我覺得好就好在我哋新嘅一個新一代嘅 generation 會有多啲唔同佢哋自己嘅 insight 擺喺佢哋創作裏邊。依個價值觀係同以前嘅會有啲唔同嘅，所以我覺得係好事嚟嘅，因為我覺得一個健康嘅創作環境，一個健康嘅創作工業是需要有不同的類型、不同的睇法在那個 pool 裏面，咁先係一個健康 的一個生態。
咁我呢個最後問題就基本上是問俾兩個，但係就有少少唔同嘅。So same question but different a little variation between the two. So I'll ask Gin Long first。你覺得一個新導演要有啲乜嘢可以幫到佢喺呢個行業生存咧？
我自己覺得作為新導演都是要 keep 住自己的熱情，即係我都會，你咁一講，我都會諗下其他答案嘅。咁係咪做人定係點咧？就係做人溝通嘅技巧，咁啊未必。但係你呢啲一定係要需要有啦。咁但係我覺得創作嘅熱誠就係需要保留住咯。因為我覺得做得耐，或者我哋人對住一件事物對得耐，都會慢慢磨滅咗某一啲嘅感覺嘅。所以我覺得係要 keep 住當每一套都係你最後一套嘅作品去做。咁就會有一個感染到人哋嘅力量喺裏邊。
So between different variation but same question, what do you think a new actor? What quality do you think a new actor has to have to survive in the Hong Kong film industry?
Well, I'm very very new, so I might not be able to give the most accurate answer. But you know, from me being an actor in this film.And asking myself, introspecting, okay, how I am, I felt like I had good intentions. I wanted to make use of this opportunity to create open doors, perhaps in Hong Kong, maybe there might be a segregation, discrimination, whatever. Hopefully, and I hoped.However my performance was, however, of course, also the story and all that, I hoped it will at least have an impact to make everything a bit better, at least. So, and also as an actor, I feel just being true to myself, you know, it's a cliche, you know, be yourself, but, you know, I try to be, because he finally said, oh, you're like,I met Gordon Lam. He was like, "Oh, you are Lehe Mande. You are Manny." And he asked him, "What did you cast me?" And he just said, "He's like, intuition." That's all he said. And I'm like, okay, then I guess I just have to find whatever they think they saw in me. So, you know, I guess just be true to yourself and try to find what is in you that is related to the character that you have to play. So.That's what I'm thinking for now. So I hope that helps. Yeah.
So that's all we have time for today. I want to thank Bipin and Gin Long for coming to talk to us. Good luck with the release of the film. And thank you everyone for staying to watch this Q&A.
Thank you guys.